In a previous video, I talked about how to maximize the range of a projectile launched from a height above level ground. Here, we'll look at a different scenario that I came up with. I tried Googling it, but I still haven't seen it anywhere else, so if you have seen it before, leave a comment and let me know. For this one, we're moving indoors. Imagine you're in a hallway, and you have some sort of gizmo that launches a projectile. Could be a slingshot, or if you're like me, you discover that you can use a binder clip to launch another binder clip. So then you wonder, how can I maximize the distance this thing travels before it hits the floor? What makes it interesting is that you can hold the launcher at any height between the floor and the ceiling, and you can launch at any angle. Should you hold it up high and aim straight? Should you hold it down low and aim upwards? Or is it better to be somewhere in between? Of course, if the projectile hits the ceiling, it loses all momentum and drops to the floor. Well, assuming you have unlimited ammunition or unlimited time, you could try a whole bunch of different combinations and see which ones work best. Playing around with different launch velocities, you'll see that if the launcher is weak, you'll want the launch close to the ceiling to get a boost from that starting height. And if the launcher is strong, it's better to be lower so that you can aim upwards, giving the projectile more airtime. So the question is, can you compute the height and angle that will give the maximum range given the launch speed and the ceiling height? To keep this problem within the reach of casual math fans like myself, we'll need to set aside air resistance. Obviously, if we're launching Nerf darts, we'd have to add drag into the equations, and we'd get trajectories like this one. But that really complicates things, to the point where we'd have to use numerical methods to calculate the range, and that wouldn't be much fun. So let's just assume we're shooting big heavy marbles, and that with the speeds and distances we're talking about here, simple parabolas will be close enough to give a good sense of where the launch point should be. With that said, this problem isn't as hard to solve as you might think, and yet it's not particularly elegant either. I don't have any clever insight that lets us bypass the calculus and the algebra as I did in my other video. So rather than spending the rest of this video doing algebra, I'll just talk about the problem a bit more, and then challenge you to work out the answer yourself. Pause now if you don't want any hints. The first thing you'll want to notice is that for maximum range, the projectile will reach the maximum allowable height. If it doesn't, then you can make it go farther simply by raising the launch point. This means that if we somehow knew the ideal height, we could easily compute the corresponding ideal angle, and vice versa. In other words, we have a constraint that ties the two variables together, and that conveniently reduces the scope of the problem. So step one would be to establish that height-angle relationship. Let's define some variables. I'll use capital H for the maximum height the projectile can reach without touching the ceiling. I'm using 3 meters for this animation. Let's use H-naught for the initial height, capital S for the launch speed, and theta-naught for the launch angle. So how might we go about finding a formula to relate the height and the angle? Well, we need the launcher to give the projectile just enough energy to reach the ceiling, which suggests using the conservation of energy. Here are the formulas for kinetic energy, 1/2 the mass times the square of the speed, and for the potential energy, mass times the gravity of Earth times height. Since air resistance is not a significant factor, the sum of these two energies at any point in the flight will be very close to constant. So we can equate the total energy at the starting point, where the speed is s and the height is h-naught, with the total energy at the point where it reaches its maximum height, where the speed is s cosine theta-naught, and the height we can say is capital H, because that's what we need it to be. Okay, so the next step would be to derive an equation for the distance the projectile will travel, and then find the maximum of that function. Here's the general equation for a projectile's height as a function of time, and one for the distance traveled as a function of time. I think that's enough to get you going. If you want more suggestions, I'll put some in the description. Before I go, let's look at a graph of the final equations with launch speed on the x-axis and the ideal height and angle on the y-axis, with the ceiling height set at 3 meters. As we saw from the experimental launches, lower speeds require a higher launch point, and as the launch speed increases, the ideal height comes down. As you can see, the experimental data was pretty accurate. Note that the height equation will go negative at some point, since the math doesn't take into account the existence of a solid floor. And so you get a discontinuity as you're forced to keep the height at zero as the launch speed continues to increase. Well, I hope you enjoy thinking about this problem, and if you do choose to work on it, let me know in the comments what you come up with. And remember, whether you're launching Nerf darts, binder clips, or big heavy marbles, please be sure to launch responsibly. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.